Hello again. We're gonna play the same game, just different rules. Lilo, could you not? So this time, anytime you see the letter E, you can start dancing. So we have a round. A R O U N D. Any. A N Y. Any. Not. N O T. Not. Oop. Ride, RIDE, ride. It's ITS, it's back, BACK, back. Out, OUT, out. Just, JUST, just. Hour, OUR, hour. Sleep, SLEEP, sleep. Before. Oh, short. B E F O R E. Before. Tap and play. Okay. Over. O V E R. Over. I'm. Than, THAN, than. But, BUT, but. Them, THEM, them. Where? WHERE, where? They, THEY, they. Last one, one, O N E, one. Now we're gonna read The Hares and the Frogs, retold by Michelle Palmieri, pictures by Giuliano Ferri something. Okay. The Hares and the Frogs. So you should be able to read along. One day, the hares went up the big hill. I think it's time for lunch, one said. They set off to find grass and twigs. Hares, as you know, are full of fear. So, as they had lunch, they kept alert. You can see their ears up, they're looking all around. It was not long before one hare sat up in a rush. Sniff, sniff, an animal was close by. Run, the hares yelled, and off they ran as fast as they could. Think about the name of the book and what animal it's probably going to be, or a creature. But it was just a sheep. The hares felt bad for running off. They went over to the shrubs to rest. When some twigs went snap, they got up in a flash and fled. Fled is another word for running away quickly. But it was just the ducks. The big hare said, "We are a sad bunch. We let fear rob us of food and rest. Let us find a spot to hide. We may not have the grass there, but we will be safe. We will not be afraid." With that, the hares set off. On the path, there was a pond. A group of frogs sat by the bank. So the bank is the area around the pond. As the hares went by, the frogs went into the pond. Plop, plop, they hid. "Look," said a hare, "did you see the frogs jump? Things are not so bad after all." "We are not the only ones who are afraid. Even the frogs ran and hid from us." We all have fears to face. So more. A fable. So this is a fable. A fable is a short story that teaches a moral or lesson. Aesop's fables have been retold for thousands of years and continue to teach and entertain. Aesop's name has been linked to hundreds of fables. Although the hares in this fable are fictional, in some ways they behave like real animals. Hares are usually solitary, but they may forage or look for food in groups. While they forage, the groups watch for predators. If a predator gets too close, hares use their strong legs to run away. They can reach top speeds of 45 miles per hour. So maybe think of some of the other fables we've read. Think about the lessons we learned from them, like the tortoise and the hare, and the ant and the grasshopper. What were the lessons of those stories? What was the lesson of this story? What did those rabbits need to learn, or those hares need to learn? Okay, have a good day.